in, and we're just about set to kick off. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bowling Green has lined up for the kickoff, and we're ready to get this one underway. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 29-yard line. Pittsburgh's coaching staff, they know they've got a star wide receiver. They know it's going to be a hostile environment. With that, we went to practice this week, Kirk. They had the crowd noise pumped up pretty good getting them ready for this game.
Yeah, they've done everything that they can do to get this offense ready for a tough environment. They had the crowd noise all week long, making it tough to communicate to the quarterback and his receivers. Now it's here. Now it's the game. We'll see if all that preparation pays off. One thing we know for sure, they want to get the football into the hands of this receiver early and often if they want to win this game.
Second down and 7. Ball on the 32. Tackle around the 41-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
And down he goes at the 49.
Gain of 10 on the play. That'll make it second and inches.
So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Brought down at the 42. It's complete for about 7 yards and a first down.
And how about the poise of this quarterback to locate his receiver past the sticks and get him the ball? That was a great throw.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. He's got an opening. He's at the 30. He's pushed out of bounds around the 20-yard line.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Here's an opening, and they make the stop at the 4-yard line. They go with a run, and he's brought down in the backfield. And the linebacker comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
Second down, goal to go. 6 yards to the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh! Plowed his way into the end zone there. Great looking touchdown.
Once you get inside the 10-yard line, this halfback is automatic.
They got to him early, but didn't get quite enough of him. And he hits the PAT. So an 8-play, 71-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Well, the blocking up front was just amazing. I think that's what led them to those big runs.
He just drills this one. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Under heavy pressure. Now he's going to run and watch out. Slides down. He made a real nice play on that one.
I'll tell you what, in today's game, you have to have the ability to run the football. Give the quarterback a lot of credit. He made a great play and really gave his team a boost.
He's tackled at about the 39-yard line. Now he's scrambling. He's taken down at the 42-yard line. The quarterback scramble gains 3 yards. Third down. Scrambling around. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. He dropped it. And he's tackled at the 33-yard line. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Pittsburgh is up a score. He gets out to about the 44-yard line.
That's a gain of 11 on the play. First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. Decent run here, right side.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. From the 34-yard line, first down.
Mike check, 33.
And he's taken down at the 26-yard line. Bennett gets 8 yards on the play.
That makes it second and 2.
He's got it out to his tight end. They'll bring him down at the 18.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 18-yard line. He makes it to the 18-yard line.
No gain. That brings up second and 9.
Got a man, watch out here. Touchdown, Panthers. And that one worked just like they draw it up, Kirk.
Yeah, Brad, you're exactly right. Offensive line did a good job of protecting the quarterback. Good route by the receivers. Results, touchdown.
That's a great touchdown, Brad, but what happened to the coverage there by the defense? The defensive coordinator's got to be beside himself. You know, you work all week long on studying an offense and their tendencies, and then to have a mental error and to leave the star receiver open like that for a touchdown? Well, they've got to regroup.
It's fielded at the 2, brought down at the 22. So at the end of one quarter, the Panthers lead 14-0. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime.
Now he tries to buy some time, and he can't get away from the pressure.
Loss of three on the play. That brings up second and 13.
So it's second down and 13 yards to go following that quarterback sack. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. Quick throw out to the receiver. Recovered by the defense. To the 20. Tackle made at the 14. That's a big break for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with the turnover bug. They need to hold on to the football.
So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble. And the booth is going to take a few looks at this to see whether or not the ball came out before he was down.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
Green gains around 3 yards on that draw play.
That'll make it fourth and two.
He's taken down the 38-yard line. The Panthers' offensive staff, I think, has done a good job of keeping their wide receiver in the game. Even though he's not having great stats, he's part of it, and the rest of the team now is picking up his slack, I think.
Well, this offense is still putting points on the board, and I think at times they're actually using the wide receiver, the go-to man who's drawing so much attention, really as a decoy, open up other avenues of this offense. We've seen other receivers make some plays. They're running the football. So it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments this defense makes to try to slow down these other members of this offense, and who knows, maybe that could open it back up for that marquee receiver.
From their own 34-yard line. Second down. And he's stopped behind the line.
Quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
He's tackled at the 40-yard line.
Returns for a gain of 10 yards.
Their last drive broke down and they punted. What do they have in store this time out? And he's tackled at about the 41. And he's going to come up with a sack. It looks like the defensive end that got in there.
Yes, it was. He did a wonderful job of fighting off blocks to bring the quarterback down.
Third down now, and they need to get it out to the 50. To the 20, the 10. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal. Dangerous throw. This one's picked off.
Hendricks makes the interception.
Boy, just when it looked like they had a chance to get right back into this game, they throw the interception. Now, it's still early. Let's see if their defense can bail them out.
It's first down. And as they come up to the line, they're going to be in the shadow of their own goalpost. Carries the ball for a nice game.
Held a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
Hey, we got time right, time right. Four down. Mike check, 33.
There he goes. Gains his way to the 19-yard line.
That's a gain of 9 on the play. First down.
From their own 19-yard line. First down. Gets out to about the 21.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That makes it second and 8.
Check, tight right. Go up there, check it out, up there. Four down. Mike, check, 33.
He'll keep it on the ground again, and he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. Third down, 8 yards to go. Ball on their own 21. Down in the open field.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
The Panthers saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action. Crosses out to the tailback on the screen.
And he is drilled
at the 38. Pittsburgh's going to use their first time out of the half here. This is the 8th play of this drive.
Second and 3.
Fires it out. Tackle at the 47. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
This has been a very steady drive so far. It's first and 10, and we're right around midfield. Nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
Nice throw to hit the out route against man coverage for a first down.
So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
The ruling on the field will stand. He caught it.
The only thing left to say about this play is that was an excellent catch.
Mike check, 33.
Just throws this one away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. Defense coming and the ball comes out. The defense falls on it. So it's the cornerback that comes up with a fumble, and this ball will change hands.
Fumbles will absolutely drown an offense. It's hard to get into a rhythm when you make mistakes like that.
The offense will take the field, hoping for a better result than their last drive.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
Number 6, the intended receiver on the play.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. Delay, and he's brought down immediately. And the defense just swarmed over him on that one.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball.
Let's see if the momentum from that defensive stand carries over to their offense.
Was the intended receiver on the play. That brings up 4th and 11.
He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Pittsburgh's been playing like a well-oiled machine in this first half. And, Kirk, are we going to see more of the same in the second?
Well, I think as long as they can maintain the proper frame of mind, I think they've got a great shot to be able to pull away and win this game decisively. But the challenge for them will be listening to their coaches at halftime and continuing to play with that same aggressive attitude that they played with in the first half.
Gets it. He's in space. And down he goes around the 28-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Makes it out to about the 39. It's been a well-fought game as we head to the half. 14-0, Panthers.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
These teams only play one game a week, only 12 games in a normal regular season. I think fans have a hard time understanding why their squad can come out and play without any energy, any emotion. Keep it real with us. Tell us what it's like. Why is it hard for a player sometimes in a game like this?
Well, if the fans showed the same emotion, then maybe we would too as a player. Because think about it. When I walk out there and I'm playing one of the big dogs, the stadium's rocking. They're going crazy. They're going ballistic. They're hydrated. You know exactly what's going on. They're into it. They've been tailgating for hours. Well, there's a reason these little games, they don't get up for us. They don't get as excited. They're not yelling and screaming as much. But you could turn the, it's like you turn the volume down at home. I mean, you can hear the difference. I know the difference. I know I'm supposed to beat this opponent. It's really a matter of just by how much I'm supposed to win by. So there is a difference. You can feel it in the fans, and you can feel it sometimes as a player.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk ready to roll.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half.
Set to return.
He's to the 20. Room around the corner. Tackle at the 42. The Panthers continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
He's at midfield, and they make the stop at the 47-yard line.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run, and that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
Incomplete, and that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
Second and 10.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. Quick throw. He's going to try and scramble. He's taken down at the 34-yard line. He got the first down and much more.
I'll tell you what, this guy is a threat every single time he touches the ball.
And he hits him hard at the 22-yard line. And we got an injured player on the field. From the 22-yard line, first down.
Yeah.
gives it left side. Tackled for a loss. And they get nice yardage on that run. They need to convert down here and end their red zone woes. Brought down around the 14-yard line.
That's a gain of three on the play. Fourth down.
It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. Touchdown, Falcons. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
Big time play, taking that ball all the way in. Maybe the defense wasn't expecting a run.
But these guys won't give up. That 14-point deficit this offense was facing a minute ago can disappear really fast, especially with all the time left in this game.
And he converts the extra point. The Falcons had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. Tate is lined up to kick this one off. He'll take it from the two. Tackle made at the 27-yard line.
Kickoff returns 25 yards.
They're ready to begin another drive. The Falcons running back down there on the sideline. He was injured earlier. He means a lot to this offense, but I think he's going to be able to come back in. Looks like he's ready to go. Nice run, and he's brought down.
Called a gain of 5 yards. That makes it second and six.
It's second down, six to go. Ball on the 32-yard line. Pittsburgh is up a score. Bennett gets another carry, and he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. Nice play by the defense to bring up fourth down.
The defender made a solid effort to get to the ball there. Nice stop.
He's taken down at the 40. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Throws it in a hurry. Knocked out of bounds at the 48. Catches it, but they knock him out before he can get back to the original line of scrimmage.
Loss of 1 yard on the play. That'll bring up second and 11.
Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. They'll bring him down around the 47-yard line.
2 yards. That'll make it third and 9.
Setting up blockers, a running back's got it on the screen. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 43-yard line. The screen is good for 4.
They executed the screen play well here by getting the ball to the halfback. They pick up some yards.
The punter is going to try to pin them deep in their own territory with a good punt here. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. Bowling Green's not going to back down from anybody, Herbie. I guess at least not today.
No, not today. They played with a chip on their shoulder. They've stood toe-to-toe with the big boys, and I don't think they're finished yet.
They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Pittsburgh is up 7. He's tackled at the 22.
That makes it 2nd and 8.
2nd and 8 coming up here. Ball on the 22-yard line. get with a run, and he brought down in the backfield. Taken down at the 48-yard line.
Snelling with the tackle at the 48-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
From their own 48-yard line, it's first down. Tackle made at the 43.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and one.
We've got time left, time left. Four down. And check by 33.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. After a decent pickup. Brilliant work by both defenses through three quarters of play. Who can open it up in the fourth quarter? Whoever does has got a great chance to win. Pittsburgh's lead is a touchdown. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Pittsburgh up 7 points. He fights forward to about the 29.
Gain of 3 yards. That'll bring up third and two.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Up the middle for a nice gain. Third down has been the charm on this drive.
Now, it's been all about execution. When it comes to calling the right play at the right time, they've been able to do it here.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Here's a run up the gut, but nothing going there. Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 23-yard line. And he's tackled around the 21-yard line.
Gain of 2 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
This is the 11th play of this drive. Slings it out there incomplete.
He was a little erratic on that pass, but there's no denying that he can really hum it in there.
So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. The kick is up, and they tack on 3 points. They line up to kick this one away. It's fielded at the 2. Brought down at the 21-yard line.
The Panthers have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it set up their offense to be able to score points.
The offense is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive as they had to punt the ball away the last time they had it. Pass complete and taken down immediately.
Second and 3.
And a quick throw. Tackles at the 49-yard line.
He showed some excellent moves out there. More than you usually expect from a tight end. That was a big gain, and this offense keeps humming along.
Quick throw out to the receiver. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
Yeah.
Makes the first down catch. He steps out at the 24. He's on the run, and down he goes at the 23.
Gain of 1 yard.
No hole.
That brings up second and 9.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call.
False start, offense.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Still second down.
Second and 14. Ball on the 28.
Down. Motion. Motion.
He passes it, and he can't make the catch.
Number 10, the intended receiver on the play. That brings up third and 14.
Is out to the tailback on the screen. Loose football. It's picked up by the defense. So the offense turns over the pigskin.
The ball carrier here was just careless in handling the ball. And a great awareness by the defense to jump on it.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep. Those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
He scrambled, and they get the sack.
I think they had to go for it given the circumstances. They just couldn't pull it off.
The offense just wasn't able to make a play. The defense was really clutch right there. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. Just over 2 minutes in the game. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Bennett comes away with 5 yards on the carry. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Bowling Green will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. The Falcons call a timeout. That's their second of the half. On the ground, right side. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. The Falcons using their third and last timeout. They take over after the punt, needing to put some points up on the board.
They need to score here, then recover an onside kick and score again. Although this game isn't over yet, I just don't think they can accomplish that feat with this much time left in the game.
Caught with room to work, and they make the stop around the 43-yard line. Throws complete. He's got room to work. And he shoved out of bounds at the 31. First and 10. Ball on the 31. He's taken down at the 19. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. There's a strike complete. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
That makes it
middle to his tailback. And he's level at the three. Green picks up 6 yards with that grab.
That brings up second and goal.
And they push him out
around the 3 yard line.
Here we go. Third and goal from the 3 yard line. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
Man, I don't know if this quarterback misread the defense or just made a poor decision, but that wasn't a pass he should have thrown.
Quick throw in the end zone, touchdown.
Late in the fourth quarter, and the big question is, in a game this close, who's going to crack first?
The draw within a field goal. He makes the PAT. He's tackled at the 41-yard line.
Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't?
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. From the 44-yard line, second down, under a minute left. Down, right around the 26-yard line.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
Pittsburgh's team right now aware that they are a team. Hey, they're starting to shine today. Everybody else picked up the pace, though.
I think we all came in expecting to see that star player really shine. And the fact that they didn't have a great game from him and still won the football game, boy, I walked away from this game as a viewer just thinking even that much more about this team than maybe what I thought prior to the football game.